The Apollo moon landing cemented the United States as the unquestioned leader in space travel. When Buzz Aldrin and Neil Armstrong placed the flag on the moon, the U.S. reached the figurative finish line at the end of a years-long space race. But fast forward 60 years, through numerous NASA-led missions to space, and the U.S. space program has ended up with budget cuts and no vehicle to launch astronauts into space. Without the space shuttle, NASA now relies on Russians to send Americans to space from a launch pad in Kazakhstan. But if billionaires like Elon Musk and Jeff Bezos are to be believed, space is about to become a big business. As a result, China is pouring money into its fast-growing private space industry to get a piece of the action, showing its commitment to the future of space exploration.
In 3 years, China has gone from representing 0% of the world's investment in the space industry to 3% of the world's investment in the space industry. That may not seem like a lot, but that's enough to put China regularly in among the top countries investing in space companies.
The space race of today isn't just about proving who has the fastest rocket. It's about business interests, Mars exploration, and ultimately, control of natural resources, commercial space travel, and more. Back in 2009, SpaceX made history when it became the first private company to send a commercial satellite into space. Companies no longer had to employ the help of a government in order to get a satellite into space. The private sector could now start to help out with that. Fast forward 10 years, and companies like SpaceX and Jeff Bezos' Blue Origin have made impressive strides in their space program, and so have Chinese companies. In 2018, China's OneSpace completed the first suborbital launch of a rocket, and this year, they plan to send over 10 commercial satellites into space. That took SpaceX 7 years to do. Still, China's space ventures aren't quite to the point of overtaking American giants like SpaceX.
Even the newer rocket that LandSpace is developing can only lift barely even a fifth of the payload that SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket can lift.
But where China excels is its rapid growth in space industry investment for these companies. The real strength of commercial satellite launch programs is that it frees up governments to focus on much larger aspirations. China's CNSA made itself a real contender for the modern space race when it launched its lunar probe on the far side of the moon in 2018, a first for any country. This has led many to speculate that China's got its sights on much bigger projects, but some experts say that the country's space program isn't done with the moon quite yet.
They're gonna put boots on the ground on the moon soon. That's part of their plan, right? They've rolled that out, they've announced that publicly.
And some see that as a potential step towards a much further goal.
A lot of the international world kind of shrugged off, like, oh, you reached the far side of the moon with a robot. We did that 50 years ago on the front side of the moon with human beings. It would be a little more difficult to shrug off them actually having a sustained presence on the surface of the moon with something like a lunar outpost of sorts. That would be, as many within the space industry as well as NASA refer to it, a kind of gateway step to reaching Mars.
Mars is the ultimate dream for governments and companies alike. It's the next frontier of space travel, but China has a long way to go.
I just think the U.S. has too big of a lead here, and that has a lot to do with SpaceX. I mean, if SpaceX wasn't in the picture, then I think that there would be a much bigger risk of that happening. But with SpaceX innovating the way that they have and continuing to innovate at the pace that they are, I don't think that anyone's gonna get to Mars before SpaceX.
NASA's private partnerships could help the US beat China to Mars. The ultimate goal for companies and countries alike expands far beyond exploration for exploration's sake. Whoever holds the keys to space ultimately has access to vast resources and unknown technological advances. And as researchers and engineers begin exploring the viability of asteroid mining, space is going to become even more important to a country's economy and a business's bottom line. There's also the increase in militarization of space, with President Trump's announcement of the Space Force in 2018. All of these factors will make space more competitive in the future and drive a space race that's just getting started.